Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. If you're one of these seven people, you're definitely going to Jannah, inshallah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "The sun will get closer to the creation on the day of resurrection, until it's 1 mile away. People will perspire according to the level of their deeds. Some of them will have perspiration covering his ankles, some to his knees, others to their shoulders. Some will have it to choke them." And he pointed towards his mouth. And he also said that there are seven whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will shade in his shade on the day when there is no shade except his shade. Number one, a just ruler or leader. You see, justice in Islam is extremely important. And it's most important for the ruler to be just to the people, regardless of seeing that they're rich or poor. A ruler must keep in mind that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who can raise the ranks of the people. If you're in any position to rule or command, it's only because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A just ruler is the one who gives rights to all people, whether they're Muslim, non-Muslim, relative, stranger, friend or enemy, doesn't matter. Therefore, it's promised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep him under his shade. Number two, a young man who grew up in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, the Prophet said, "Take benefit of five before five. Your youth before your old age. Your health before your sickness. Your wealth before your poverty. Your free time before you're preoccupied. And your life before your death." Number three, a man whose heart is attached to the masjid. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "A masjid is the house of every pious, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted comfort and mercy for everyone whom the mosque is his house, and that they will traverse to the bridge or as sirat to Allah's pleasure and paradise." Number four, two people who love each other purely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How beautiful is that? Just to love this person, just for the sake of Allah, simply for the sake of Allah. I don't love him for the fame or for the money or I want his sister or his daughter. No, I just love this guy for the sake of Allah. I just love him. The Prophet said, on the day of resurrection, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, "Where are those who have mutual love for the sake of my glory? Today I shall shelter them in my shade when there is no shade except mine." Number five, a man who refuses the call of a woman of beauty and status. And of course, the best example we can take here is the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. When the wife of the Aziz, who was one of the most beautiful ladies in Egypt, tried to seduce him, however, he resisted. Number six, a man who gives charity in secret, such that his left hand does not know what the right hand gave. So stop taking selfies while giving charity, okay? Number seven, and this is the most beautiful for me, a man who remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in private, and he shed tears. That's so beautiful. Listen to this hadith. The Prophet said, "Hellfire is haram for a believer whose eyes shed tears for Allah. The face of a person whose cheek has become wet with a teardrop will never fall on bad times. On the day of resurrection, all things will be measured and weighed. Of them, the tears streaming down out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are strong enough to quench oceans of fire." And he also said, "There is not a drop dearer to Allah than two drops. A drop of tear rolling down out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a drop of blood shed in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Alright, thank you for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.